For those of you who don't know, I'm Pam Africa. I'm Minister of Confrontation for the MLK organization. And I do take that very, very seriously. Because sometimes people take on titles, and that's all it is. But the reality of the Minister of Confrontation, one of and all of those that's in MLK, is very serious about what is happening. Today is very, very serious for us. I'm here to let you know I got something to make me want to shout.
Come on!
And on yesterday,
tell us like it is.
In 1977, in Philadelphia, because the MLK organization took a stand against a government who had beat, maimed, killed babies. One of our babies, 3-year-old Life Africa, was snatched out of his mother's arms and dropped to the ground and, you know, killed. His head was just bust open. My sister Albert, I'm just giving you a little background in here because I'm not leaving King. And all because what's happening, what is synonymous with, you know, us and King is that no matter how this government came after us, and all, we was determined to put the truth out. And all, you know, not just for us, but for the everybody that's involved here. When we was dealing with the situation of water, the air, and they talk about the Clean Air Act, the Clean Water Act, it is just that. It is an act. And all these bills that are passed, if they was real, we would not be still talking about the act. We would be talking about the fact that, oh my God, you can cut on your faucet and you can get some water. And when we go into the supermarket, we would not have to make choices between rows and rows and rows of water. We would not be going to the store and to a health food store to get water and it's in plastic. God do not even accept plastic into the earth. It's consistently spitting it out. But I'm saying, you know, the simplicity. The fact that you can go to a health food store, I have not left King, I have not left Mumia, I have not left MLK, when you can go into a store and the food that you're getting, you're not familiar with. I see seasoned people in this room. You know what a sweet potato look like. You remember the hair? Do you remember potatoes had spuds on it? Do you remember that, you know, carrots and all will sprout. If you go into a supermarket today, there's no sprouting. When you go to get a watermelon and you get a watermelon that don't have seeds, when you get a lemon that don't have seeds, what are you eating? That is something that's not from God. You know what I'm saying? We have not left Martin. We have not left Moon. We have not left Mumia. I'm saying when you go, and I remember years ago, our coordinator, John Africa, told us that, you know, it's not going to be long before you could be buying air. Could not understand, could not see it. And how many people walking around with bought air on their back because you cannot consume, you cannot breathe the air that is here. I'm not, I have not left Martin, I have not left Mumia, I have not left Malcolm, I have not left many of you in this room who continuously stand up and fight this government. And when you do, Martin Luther King was locked up 29 times. I might have it wrong, it might have been 30. I bring that to you to say, locked up, beat up, shot, and he wasn't by himself. Just like this room is full of people who stand up against this government, there was a many more. Jamil Alameen. Who is Jamil Alameen? H. Rap Brown, this brother today, sits in jail because they could not kill him outright like they did King. So they come up with some other kind of way. Who is H. Rap Brown? Do many people in here know what this brother sacrificed for us when we talk about we stand on the shoulders of? Do you really know? Martin marched with, he was one of the advisors to H. Rap Brown. H. Rap Brown, if you want to get rid of 45, you know, they have an H. Rap Brown. Y'all know who 45 is, right? Okay, the H. Rap Brown law. H. Rap Brown was an activist, a black activist, and all who was a part of SCLC. Am I saying it right? Don't want to be wrong. SNCC.
Exactly.
And you know, a group of young folks, and you know, with voices to speak out like Martin and the rest of them, and voters' rights. In one city, one state, he talked about voting rights, going down and get people to stand up, for your rights. And he was accused of inciting a riot because he was going from one state to another to vote. They seen the dangers of this young brother who had the ability to pull black folks together and make them rise up, the young black folks together, because he marched with Malcolm, because he marched with a lot of people. This brother was locked up for doing just that. I want to point out that also, when they made this law and locked him up, here it is today, and we're dealing with 45. Not only do he leave one city and go to another, but he can stand before people and say, when they open their mouth, when they move, you beat them up, lock them up, and there will be, nothing would happen to you. The H. Rap Brown law should have been applied to him like they applied it to Jamil Alameen, who was born H. Rap Brown.